Hi, welcome to this Lightning presentation. FEIA for C, C++ and Embedded Development. I am Stefan Dieriks, I am a software architect at Eclipsos. Now, let's say you want to start your own FEIA-based C, C++ IDE, or you want to add C and C++ capabilities to your existing IDE. How do you go about that? To answer this question, we started the CTT.cloud Blueprint initiative. It's a template IDE and includes selected FEIA and VS Code extensions. There's an early state available. See cdt-cloud.io for more information. Now, the first question you will ask yourself is, which language server shall I choose? The most popular in the VS Code marketplace is CPP Tools by Microsoft. However, it has a very restrictive license, which means it can't be used outside of VS Code. The most popular alternative is ClangD. It's part of the LLVM project, it's fully fledged, and it can be used in FEIA and other tools. This means ClangD is the de facto choice for all existing and upcoming IDE vendors. See for example the Arduino IDE 2.0 or the KaltStudio Cloud. To note, which is very important for you, is ClangD requires that you maintain a compile commands JSON file. This is basically a compilation database and must be included in your processes. Regarding compilations, there are many, many extensions. We integrated the CMake tools, which offer us smallish UI for CMake. You can use whatever you want, basically. Regarding debug adapters, we integrated the CDT GDB from the Eclipse CDT team. If you prefer LLDB, I can recommend Code LLDB. For our embedded friends, I can recommend Native Debug and Cortex Debug. Please see their respective readmes, what chips and boards they support. Now I wanted to highlight the Debug Memory Inspector. It was recently contributed to FEIA by Ericsson. It's FEIA only, it's a memory view. It uses the debug adapter memory information, and it's part of the FEIA CPP debug package. However, technically it's not reliant on CPP. You can connect arbitrary sources to it, so it can be used for all kinds of use cases and languages. Last but not least, I wanted to highlight tracing. There's a very popular Eclipse Trace Compass project, and they're currently refactoring the architecture to also be protocol-based. There's an FEIA integration. Now, let me start up the blueprint. Here you can see it. Let's look at the source file. You can see there's some code highlighting, mouse overworks, and for example, source lookup is also not a problem. Let's demonstrate debugging. So I will start debugging here. You can see it works as expected. You can inspect the local variables. At the moment, for example, regb is 00. Let's inspect that in the memory inspector. There we can also see it. And let's step. And you can see they are changed in the original FEIA variables view as well as in the memory inspector. The memory inspector has a lot more use cases. For example, you can also diff different states of your memory. However, to showcase all of this is too much for the small Lightning presentation. Let's come to the conclusion. FEIA is a fast-moving platform, has a lot of potential, and especially in the C++ area. And FEIA has here a unique selling point over VS Code. For example, this showcase memory inspector is something which can be used by other people, by other vendors, which is not possible with all the sandbox system of VS Code. There, you hardly see any reuse in custom views. Many embedded vendors are currently adopting FEIA, which is good to know. And as you just saw, many use cases are already covered. Let me remind you, visit cdt-cloud.io to stay up to date. And with that, I hope you are now well informed, and I wish you a happy FEIACon 2021.